John chapter 20 verses 1 to 9. Christ, our paschal lamb, has been sacrificed, let us then feast with joy in the Lord. On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning, while it was still dark, and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter, and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved, and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter, and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial cloths there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloths there, and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial cloths but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed. For they did not yet understand the scripture that he had to rise from the dead. Notice how Mary ran to Peter, and the other disciple. Clearly, Peter is the recognized leader of the apostles. When John arrived at the tomb, he didn't go in, but why? Peter considered the leader, and thus Peter would have the right and responsibility to enter first. Amazing, Peter had denied Jesus three times. He must have told the other apostles what had happened, yet he possessed the moral strength to do so. In fact, he was a born leader. Their first response must have been that grave robbers preceded them to the tomb. If grave robbers had removed the body, why would they have taken the time to remove the shroud and face napkin? The shroud was still in place as if the body had risen out of it. The cloth that covered the head was neatly folded in a different place. If grave robbers had stolen the body, they wouldn't have taken time to rearrange the burial clothes. John was the first to believe. He realized that the missing body wasn't the work of grave robbers but the work of God. In order to understand the significance of the folded napkin, we need to understand a little bit about Hebrew tradition of that day. The folded napkin was a form of communication between master and servant. When the servant set the dinner table, he made sure that everything was exactly the way the master wanted it. When the table was set, the servant would wait, just out of sight, until the master had finished eating. But how would the servant know the master was finished or just stepped away from the table for a moment? If the master was finished eating, he would stand, wipe his fingers, his mouth, and clean his beard, and then would wad up that napkin and toss it onto the table. The servant would then know that it was time to clear the table. The wadded napkin meant, "I'm done." If the master got from the table and folded his napkin, then laid it neatly beside his plate, the servant would not touch the table, because the folded napkin meant, "I'm not finished, I'm coming back, certainly, Jesus will come back." Jesus improved Mary Magdala's life by removing her seven demons. The result of his action was that she became a believer and followed Jesus wherever he went. Only, John, the youngest of the apostles, had enough faith to risk his life by being present at the foot of the cross. Both Mary Magdalene and John had recognized Jesus' hand working in their lives. Naturally, they returned to Jesus, the love he had given them. Mary was puzzled about what had happened at the tomb, but Jesus' love had given John the understanding of, and the ability to apply, Old Testament readings to the present situation, and recognize their fulfillment. Revelation 22:12, "Behold, I am coming soon, I bring with me the recompense, the reward, I will give to each according to his deeds." Are you ready for the Lord's return?